Dear students, up to question number 17, they are all examples of aromatic compounds, and these examples, their names you have to write. First of all, let us take this first compound. This benzene ring along with NH2 is the base compound. Benzene ring along with NH2 is the base compound. Therefore, the base compound name is what? Aniline. Aniline. And afterwards, we should give numbers in such a way that immediate next substituent get lowest number. Means now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, prefix is 2-chloro. 2-chloro, 5-nitro, nitro, aniline it is. So, this is the IPAC name of the compound number 1. 2-chloro, 5-nitro, aniline. Now, here, the base compound is this one. It is called toluene. Now, base compounds substituent should get lowest number, therefore this is 1. After that, the numbering of the remaining chain is done in such a way that the immediate substituent get lowest number. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So therefore, prefix is 2-chloro, 4-nitro, 2-chloro, 4-nitro, toluene. So, IPAC name of this second compound is 2-chloro, 4-nitro, toluene. Now, here, OH group is there, then it is called phenol. Then CN group is there, then it is called benzonitrile. But I told you what order of means, how to select the base compound means, first priority COOH is base compound, then CHO is base compound, then OH is base compound, then NH2 is base compound, then CH3 is base compound, then OCH3 is base compound. Before OH, we have CN is base compound, then greater than OH base compound, greater than NH2 base compound, like this. Now here, on the benzene ring we have OH, and on the benzene ring CN. But CN is more preferred as a base compound than OH, because on the benzene ring COOH is more preferred than CHO, more preferred than CN, more preferred than OH, more preferred than NH2, more preferred than CH3, more preferred than OCH3. So now, phenol is not the base compound. Base compound is this one. So its name becomes benzonitrile. Benzonitrile. Then substituent of the base compound is given number 1, and numbering is done in such a way that immediate next substituent should get lowest number. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So therefore, now prefix is 2-bromo, 5-hydroxy, benzonitrile is the IPAC name. So, compound number 3, IPAC name is 2-bromo-5-hydroxybenzonitrile. Then here, this will become, there is no other chance. We should consider this only as a main chain. And this becomes the side chain. So if this is a side chain, the side chain is named as phenyl. So 1, 2. So it is phenyl is prefix, root word is eth. Then primary suffix is "-ine", and there is no functional group. So it is phenyl ethyne. Then now, there is no other option. You should consider this as the main chain because it is having a functional group, CHO, called aldehyde functional group, and this becomes the side chain. So numbering is, aldehyde should get lowest number, 1, 2, 3. So to the second carbon side chain is attached, therefore prefix is 2-phenyl, then root word is prop, primary suffix is "-ane", secondary suffix is "-al". 2-phenyl propane "-al". Now here, this 5 means benzene ring. Attached to C. Another 5 means another benzene ring. Then H2 this is. Now this is the main chain having only one carbon, root word is "-meth", primary suffix is "-ane". Then 2 phenyl groups are attached to this carbon, therefore diphenyl methane is the IPAC name of this compound number 6. Then here, to this carbon, ET2 means ethyl group, CH2, CH3. Another ethyl group, CH2, CH3 is attached. Then phenyl group means benzene ring, another benzene ring. See this benzene ring, this is called benzene ring. It can be represented like this. It can be represented as C6H5. It can be represented as 5. It can be represented as pH. pH, 5, like this, all mean the same. No confusion. So if this is the case, this becomes side chain, this becomes side chain, this becomes main chain. So main chain has how many carbons? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbons. Therefore root word is pent. And between all the carbons, the bonds are single bonds. Primary suffix is "-ane". And there is no functional group, therefore there is no secondary suffix. And to the third carbon, 2 phenyl groups are attached. Therefore, 3,3-diphenyl. Diphenyl is the prefix. So 3,3-diphenyl pentane is the IPAC name of 7th compound. Now here, this is methyl group, this is methyl group, this is methyl group. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1,3,5 trimethyl benzene. 1,3,5 trimethyl benzene. Benzene. It is also commonly called mesitylene. Mesitylene. Then, if two benzene rings are attached like this, then it is called naphthalene. This is naphthalene. If three benzene rings are attached like this, then it is called anthracene. Anthracene. But if three benzene rings are attached like this, it is called phenanthracene. So, this is naphthalene, this is anthracene, this is phenanthracene. Now here, base compound is phenol. So, phenol. So this is given 1, and numbering will be done in such a way that immediate next substituent should get least possible number, that is 2, 3, 4 and so on. So this is 2-nitrophenol, 2-nitrophenol is the IPAC name. Then this one, bromine substituent is there, amino substituent is there, but amino substituent becomes base compound. So now this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Therefore, fourth carbon is having bromine. Therefore, 4-bromo aniline. So this is, I think I have written the same, 4-bromo aniline. Now here, base compound is toluene. So toluene. So now, 1, 2, 3, therefore to the third carbon, nitro group is attached, therefore 3-nitro-toluene. Then, base compound is benzoic acid. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, therefore 4-amino benzoic acid. Benzoic acid is the IUPAC name of this compound. Now here all are nitro groups. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Therefore 1, 3, 5. Trinitrobenzene. Now here base compound is aniline. Aniline. So I'll write aniline. Aniline. Then this base compound substituent is number 1. Then this is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Therefore it becomes 2, 4, 6 trinitro aniline. Now here base compound is phenol. So this phenolic carbon is number 1. The numbering is done in such a way that immediate next substituent should get lowest number. Therefore this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5, this is 6. So therefore it is 2-chloro-5-bromo-phenol. So now this is all about nomenclature of aromatic compounds. So nomenclature of aromatic compounds along with so many examples discussed. Now, after that, this is a question from 18th one. It is like this: H2C double bond CH C double bond OH. This is a question based on the topic structure and bonding in organic molecules. Now here, this carbon is forming a double bond and two single bonds, means this carbon is sp2 hybridized. Now this carbon again double bond and two single bonds sp2. This is also double bond and two single bonds sp2. Here all the three carbons are sp2 hybridized. This oxygen do not undergo any hybridization because it is not central atom. It is terminal atom. See, always in a molecule only central atoms will undergo hybridization. So now here this bond is a sigma bond of type overlapping. sp2 hybrid orbital of carbon overlaps with s orbital of hydrogen. Then this bond is sigma sp2 of this carbon overlapping with sp2 of this carbon. Then this bond is sp2 of carbon overlapping with p orbital of oxygen, that is sigma. But another bond is formed by the overlapping of p orbital of carbon with p orbital of oxygen, that is pi bond. So now this bond is sigma sp2 dash s. Then this bond is sigma sp2 dash sp2. Then this bond is pi pp. Then this is sigma sp2 dash s, sigma sp2 dash s. So question number one is, he is asking sigma sp2 dash p bonds how many? Sp2 dash p, sp2 dash p. So this is sp2 dash p, one here, that's all. So only one, answer is one. Then he is asking sigma sp2 dash s bonds, s bonds how many? Sigma sp2 dash s bonds. So this one, then this one, 2, 3, 4. So they are how many? 4. Then he is asking sigma sp2 dash s bonds, sp2 how many? So this is sp2, sp2, this is also sp2, sp2, how many? They are 2. Then he is asking so that's all. Okay, so this is how we have to predict the type of bonds in an organic molecule. So question number 18 is over. Now question number 19, he is asking why triplet carbene is more stable than singlet carbene. Before that, I want to explain what are the products of alpha elimination and beta elimination. For example, I have CH3. C, Cl, Cl, H. Now, when it is heated with alcoholic KOH, so now it is very strong base. Strong base will take away hydrogen, and hydrogen in the form of H plus means hydrogen is giving its electron to carbon, and that hydrogen is abstracted by this OH minus base forming water. Then once the electron of hydrogen goes on to carbon, means this carbon becomes negatively charged. That negatively charged fellow will repel this. So Cl will come out in the form of Cl minus. Cl minus is an example of L minus, that is a leaving group. So here, then another product is what now? This goes here, it becomes minus. This goes here, it becomes neutral. So the product is what? CH3 C, Cl. This bond pair is gone. Therefore now, it will be like this C, C, then this CH3, then this Cl. So now this bond pair turned into lone pair. So like this. This is the electron of hydrogen. Now this has gone to Cl minus, therefore this orbital becomes empty. This is now vacant. Before that it was sp3 orbital, but bond pair gone on to chlorine, it becomes vacant p orbital. So like this, now you will get, this is a reaction intermediate, reaction intermediate, not final product. This reaction intermediate is called carbene. So now here in this carbene, number of unpaired electrons zero, therefore sum of spin quantum numbers capital S is zero. Then spin multiplicity is equal to 2s plus 1, then 2 into 0 plus 1 is equal to 1, then this is called singlet carbene. Now here, what we are observing is H plus ion lost from this carbon, to which these two chlorines attached as functional group. So therefore, the carbon atom attached to the functional group is called alpha carbon. The next carbon is called beta carbon. Means what? Proton means H plus is called proton. Proton as well as leaving group, both are lost from the alpha carbon. Therefore, this is called alpha elimination. So always the conclusion is what? Alpha elimination means the loss of proton and the leaving group, both will happen from same carbon. Means leaving group and proton are lost from alpha carbon. That's why that elimination is called alpha elimination. Alpha elimination always gives what? Singlet carbene. So then next is beta elimination. Beta elimination is, see, let me take this CH3 as CH2 and H, then this CH, Cl, CH2, Cl. Now this is leaving group, therefore this is alpha carbon, this is beta carbon. So now when it is treated with alcoholic KOH has base OH minus, that base pulls away this hydrogen in the form of proton and forms water. Then this carbon becomes, now this becomes lone pair. Now bond pair turned lone pair. So therefore this negative carbon will repel this inductive effect, negative charge on this, then this will come out in the form of Cl minus, that is Cl minus is leaving group, then plus Cl minus leaving group, then when this is gone, this becomes plus, this plus fellow pulls this here, then forms H2C double bond CH2, this is called alkene, and that is which alkene? Ethene it is. If you observe, H plus means proton is lost from beta carbon and Cl minus is lost from alpha carbon. Here proton is lost from alpha carbon, that's why it is alpha elimination. Here proton is lost from beta carbon, it is called beta elimination. Beta elimination gives alkene. So alpha elimination gives carbene, a reaction intermediate. Beta elimination gives alkene, a final product. So alpha elimination gives carbene, beta elimination gives alkene. In both the cases, the reagent is alcoholic KOH. So, singlet carbene, that is. So, alpha elimination, that is, I can write dehydrohalogenation, means hydrogen is going and halogen is going, dehydrohalogenation, means what? Cl minus eliminated from alpha carbon. Proton eliminated from alpha carbon. Then it is called alpha elimination. That gives this type of product. So this type of product. It is called singlet carbene. Then, suppose this is methane. When it is subjected to sunlight or UV light, then this photon will break this bond half arrow means half arrow means carbon's electron going to carbon, hydrogen's electron going to hydrogen. This is called homolytic fusion. So here carbon's electron came to carbon, hydrogen gone, like this free radical is formed. Now this free radical is in now one vacant orbital. CHH. So carbon retained its electron like this. Now this bond also breaks by homolysis. Always, you know, sunlight will cause homolysis or light will cause homolysis. So now this is having one unpaired electron. So photolysis this is called, gives. Now here same structure, CH bond, but two electrons are as a lone pair. Here CH bond, but two electrons are as two unpaired electrons. So number of unpaired electrons are how many? Two. Therefore, sum of spin quantum numbers is half plus half, that is one. Then spin multiplicity is 2s plus 1, that is 2 into 1 plus 1, that is 3. It is called a triplet carbene. Triplet carbene. So if anybody asks how singlet carbene is formed, means alpha elimination of haloalkanes in presence of alcoholic KOH will give singlet carbene. Then photolysis of hydrocarbons will give triplet carbene. So now, this is singlet carbene, that is triplet carbene. Singlet carbene is not having any unpaired electron, it is diamagnetic. Triplet carbene is having two unpaired electrons, it is paramagnetic. Now, here, two bond pairs, one lone pair, therefore total number of electron pairs 3. Here, this carbon undergoes sp2 hybridization. Here, bond pair, no lone pair. Unpaired electrons are there, not lone pair. Therefore, here hybridization is sp. So as SP to hybridization with one lone pair, singlet carbene is angular in shape, and because of SP hybridization, triplet carbene is linear in shape. Now, who is having more multiplicity? That one is more stable. So, why triplet carbene is more stable than singlet carbene? The reason is spin multiplicity of triplet carbene is more than spin multiplicity of so greater the spin multiplicity, greater is the stability according to Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity. So what is Hund's rule? You have studied in atomic structure. In degenerate orbitals, electrons are filled in such a way that the species attains maximum spin multiplicity. If two electrons are kept in one orbital, then spin multiplicity becomes zero. But if two electrons kept in two separate orbitals, then spin multiplicity becomes maximum. But why more multiplicity, more stability here? This electron can come here, this electron can come here. This is called exchange. So, in triplet carbene, there is one unpaired electron, another unpaired electron. So, like this, one exchange is possible. During this exchange process, that species loses some extra energy. That energy is called exchange energy. So, triplet carbene loses some additional energy than singlet carbene in the form of exchange energy. Therefore, triplet carbene energy becomes lesser than singlet carbene. That is why triplet carbene is more stable than singlet carbene. So, why triplet carbene is more stable than singlet carbene? That explanation is also over. Then, what are the products of alpha elimination and beta elimination? That is also over. Now, differentiate carbene and methylene group. See, this is methane, this is ethane, this is ethane, I can write CH2H. Then this is propane. Difference between these two is CH2 bond this side. Difference between these two is CH2. This is called homologous series. Now here, this is indicating that somebody is there here, and it is called methylene group. But carbene is CH2, a lone pair and a vacant orbital. Now no other bonds with this is a isolated species. Whereas the CH2 is one group present in some big compound. So that is the difference between carbene and methylene group. Don't get confused here. Carbene formula will be like this. Sorry, methylene group formula is like this. Carbene formula is like this. So, this is the difference between carbene and methylene group. So, coming to differentiate carbene and methylene group, this question is also over. Now, in the aliphatic compounds, We have not discussed about one functional group. That functional group is called, so many functional groups we have discussed, but this is a peculiar functional group. Functional group, name of the functional group is acid anhydride. Acid anhydride. Now, nomenclature of acid anhydrides, let us see. I will write now RCOOH. This is also written as RC double bond OH. Now, its name is, now root word, how many carbons are there in the main chain? We are not sure. Therefore, then the root word becomes alk. Single bonds are there, alkane. So, OH. Acid. So IPAC name of this is alkanoic acid. When this alkanoic acid is heated with P4O10 is a strong dehydrating agent. So this is one and this is another, 2 moles will react. So this OH and H will go out in the form of water. So, minus water. As water is going out, this phenomenon is called dehydration. For that, we are using this reagent called P4O10. P4O10 is called dehydrating agent. So, when this goes out, then we are left with R, C, double bond O. Then this carbon will be attached to this oxygen. Then C, double bond O, R. Now, in this, this one is called anhydride, means after the an means after the loss of water. So after the loss of water from acid, we get acid anhydride. This is acid. After the loss of water from acid, we will get acid anhydride. So now this particular one here I'll write, that is C double bond O bond C double bond O, this is called acid anhydride functional group. So this is called this functional group, acid anhydride. This acid anhydride functional group, in short I can write CO taken twice, CO, CO, O, bond this side. Now, IPAC name of the acid is alkanoic acid. Then IPAC name of this anhydride will be alkanoic anhydride. Alkanoic anhydride. Okay? So that is the IPAC name. Now suppose, if I take CH3 here, then here will be CH3. Here also will be CH3. If CH3 is there, alk becomes eth because 2 carbons are there. Then IPAC name of this compound becomes ethanoic acid. Then here you will get CH3. Then here you will get CH3. Then IPAC name of this anhydride will become ethanoic anhydride. Ethanoic anhydride. So, ethanoic anhydride, in short I will write CH3 here. So that is ethanoic anhydride. Now suppose here this is CH2 CH3, then it becomes propanoic acid, but this is ethanoic acid. Then here you will have CH2 and here CH3. Then this is called ethanoic propanoic anhydride. Ethanoic propanoic propanoic oic anhydride. Now suppose only propanoic acid alone is heated with it P4O10, then here you will get CH3, CH2, then the name just becomes propanoic anhydride. Propanoic anhydride. So to the acid name, you have to add anhydride. Alkanoic acid, alkanoic anhydride. Methanoic acid, methanoic anhydride. Ethanoic acid, ethanoic anhydride. Propanoic acid, propanoic anhydride. Ethanoic and propanoic acid together heated with P4O10, then ethanoic propanoic anhydride. So this is the nomenclature of acid anhydrides. Then the last question, 23rd, he is asking which of the following has isopropyl group. Then A option is 2, 2, 3, 3 tetra methyl pentane. Then B option is 2, 2 dimethyl pentane. Then C option is 2, 2, 3 trimethyl pentane. Then fourth option is 2-methyl pentane. Now this is the question, the last question, that is. Here, first of all, I will write IPAC names of, I will write the structures. A structure is, what is the root word? Pent. Pent means there are 5 carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbons. And at carbon 2, there are 2 methyl groups. And at carbon 3, there are 2 methyl groups. So remaining is hydrogens, CH2, CH3. So this is the structure of first compound. What I did is, pent means I have written 5 carbons in the main chain. An means I have put all single bonds. Then on second carbon, 2, 2 dimethyl. And third carbon, 3, 3. Total tetramethyl. So this is A. Then B. B is again pentane. Here I'll write B. B is root word is pent. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Pent N. Then second carbon having 2 methyl groups. So B is this. Then C. Pentane again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But he is telling 2, 2, 3. So 2, 2, then 3. 3. H here, then H2, here CH3. That is C. Then D is 2 methyl pentane. This is D. Four compound structures clearly I have written. Then observe the structure and decide who is having isopropyl group. What is isopropyl group? I told many times here. this is main chain, this is side chain, this is called isopropyl group, which is also written as CH3CH3, like this means from the, this is main chain, this is opposite end, from the opposite end, if second carbon carries methyl group, then it is called iso chain. Where is that? From this side, if you take second carbon not having any methyl group, from this side, if you take second carbon is having two methyl groups, from any side, if you check, second carbon is not having just one methyl group. Here also, there is no isopropyl group. Here, this one, CH3CHCH3, this triangle is isopropyl group. So, answer is D. So, 23rd answer is D. So, after these students, we are left with nomenclature of bicyclic compounds and nomenclature of spiro compounds, which will be continued. So, dear students, coming to the nomenclature of bicyclic compounds. Nomenclature of bicyclic compounds. Nomenclature of bicyclic compounds. So, first of all, what is a bicyclic compound? Two rings. Rings connected by two common carbons. Two rings connected by two common carbons. Like this, see. Rings connected by common carbons. Okay. Let me take this one and this one. So this ring and this ring are connected by these two common carbons. Now these common carbons are called bridge heads. Bridge heads means what? This is a bridge head, this is a bridge head. Now here, how do you write the name of the bicyclic compound? Now here, we should start numbering from either this bridge head or this bridge head and proceed through the longer chain. So, numbering is started from any one of the bridge head and proceed through larger chain. So here 1, 2, 3, 4 chain. This is only 1, 2 chain. So I should proceed like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, then 7, 8. So totally in this bicyclic compound, 8 carbons are there. Therefore, root word becomes oct. Then all are single bonds here. Octane. But it is what kind of bicyclic compound? It is what kind of compound? It is not aliphatic, it is not alicyclic, it is bicyclic. Therefore, we should add a prefix called bicyclo. Bicyclo, and we should open a bracket, and in the bracket we should write number of carbons in each chain from larger to smaller. So 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons. So I'll write 4. Bicyclo, open the bracket, 4 comma, then this is 2, 4 comma 2. There can be another chain connected like this, but there is nothing like that. Therefore, I'll write comma 0. You will understand afterwards why 0. Here it is 0. Why? Because suppose this is connecting to some other fellow like this, it is having one carbon. Here in place of 0, I'll write 1. But such thing is not there. So therefore, name of this compound is bicyclo 4 comma 2 comma 0 octane. So bicyclic compound means rings connected by 2 common carbons. Those 2 common carbons are called bridge heads. Numbering is started from any one of the bridge head and proceed through larger ring. Then we should add a prefix called bicyclo. Then open a bracket, number of carbons in each part, then 3 parts means in each part, generally 3 parts. So 4, 2, 1 like that we will write, then root word, then primer suffix. This is how we have to name bicyclic compounds. Then coming to the nomenclature of spiro compounds. Nomenclature of spiro compounds. So spiro compound means this is one ring connected to another ring by only one common carbon. So rings connected by only two rings. Rings connected by only one common carbon. Now that common carbon is called spirocarbon. Now here numbering starts not from the spirocarbon, numbering starts from adjacent carbon to the spirocarbon. Numbering starts from the carbon adjacent to the spirocarbon. Not like in bicyclic compounds. And proceeds through smaller ring. Proceed through smaller ring means not this one. You should proceed like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So then name starts with prefix spiro. 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 And then open the bracket. Number of carbons in each chain. So this is having how many? 2. This is having 1, 2, 3, 4. 2 comma 4. And total number of carbons are 7. Root word is heptane. So spiro 2 comma 4 heptane is the IUPAC name of this compound. So this is all about nomenclature of spiro compounds. Then again we will study some examples of bicyclic compounds and spiro compounds. Okay? And it will be continued.